Hey guys, Wicked, you're watching Robo Airsoft.
What's up, Airsofters? It's Robo, and I'm back with another Robo Reviews, and this time around, we're gonna take care of the king of all combat suits. Wow! These are the Beyond Clothing A9A Advanced Mission Pant, or the Axios Pant that they sell. Now, these are a very custom set. They have been Cry modded, or they've been styled after a Cry G3 open knee design. And they are constructed out of the newly minted Multicam Tropic pattern, which Beyond Clothing does not yet sell retail, because these are a bit of a unicorn when it comes to combat suits on the planet here. So we're gonna start with the pants. We're gonna do top to bottom, along with direct comparisons to the Cry G3 counterparts, which these are very closely modeled after. So along the waistline, we have a high impact foam waistline, much like Cry G3's. Now, again, I haven't worn these long enough to know if that foam compresses like it does in the G3. Now the Cry G3s, I'm not saying that the foam compression's a bad thing, it's quite normal and much better than any repros out there. Now in the Beyond set here, the impact foam does feel a little bit higher density, a little bit thicker. Now again, that might just be because I haven't worn these enough to compress it like I have in the Cry G3 set. And honestly, I've had my Cry G3 set for over a year now, so I can't remember how it was when it first came out of the bag. Now, other similarities along the belt line here. The width of the waist area is pretty much identical to Cry G3's. Same with the belt loop width. They're all pretty much one-to-one Cry, or again, styled after the Cry G3 set. Same with the waist adjustments. These are a stretch Cordura, elastic Cordura, just like in the Cry's. And again, they attach via a Velcroing system along the back. So looking at the seat area of the A9As, a little bit different than Cry's, but again, still some similarities. What you have that it's different are angled pockets rather than the straight across in the Cry's. This actually allows you to get into them a lot easier. Both the Cry's and the Beyond sets do use a zippered back pocket, which is a huge thumbs up. Now, welcome addition on the Beyond set, however, is little nylon pull loops on that zipper, just so you can get into it quite easily if you're reaching past a dump pouch or any other EDC stuff you might have on your belt line. Now, some small differences over what people would recognize in a G3 set. There is no stretch elastic material like in the G3 set. Now, most are gonna throw up their arms and say, well, that's a bad thing. I like the Cry G3 stretch, and so do I. But here's where it becomes different in the Beyond and what they've done to change how this area works and to eliminate the need for elastic stretch material, at least from what I can discover here. The tailoring in the back end here is actually a little bit different than in the Cry's. Instead of a straight down tailoring that you find in the Cry G3s, you actually have little angle tacks in the fabric up here, which change the overall contour of the back end. The back end becomes a little bit more round, and that avoids any pressure spots in the seat area when you're changing positions like sitting, crouching, things like that. Now, another small thing you'll notice, there is no double reinforced seat area here. Again, I haven't worn these long enough to know that if that's a bad thing or a good thing in terms of weight conservation versus durability over the long term in comparison to the Cry G3s. But that's something to note. There is no reinforced seat area like there is in the Cry G3s. All right, now on the front side of the seat area, or the crotch area as most would call it, couple things to note. Some differences in the pocket design over the G3s. The G3s are more like a jean pocket. They're just kind of go down on a constant arc towards the side seam line. These actually follow more of a tactical tailoring kind of design. And some of you will recognize this from my Vertex Cryptek pants that I reviewed a while back. And that is the pant pocket actually comes down and cuts at a parallel angle to the ground. What this is useful for is for storing things like knives, flashlights, or other tools so that they stay put and they're easily accessible without fighting the pocket itself. The other thing with these pockets, they're not just like a normal Nyko ripstop. And this is different than the G3 design. What Beyond actually uses is a Cordura fabric, and it's actually a stretch Cordura fabric, and you're gonna see that come up in this review in a couple minutes here again. This Cordura fabric actually extends the lifetime of your pocket line. Again, if you're putting tools and taking them in and out all the time, eventually a Nyko ripstop is going to break down. Cordura will as well, but definitely not as fast. Think about it. It's the difference between wearing, say, your combat clothes versus wearing your plate carrier. You get the extra durability out of the Cordura in a place where you don't necessarily need the comfort. Now, much like the Cries, the Beyond A9As feature a Velcro enclosure for the belt line and also features a zippered crotch. Now, there's a caveat to this zippered crotch. It's not just a normal zippered fly. It's actually a split fly. And what I mean by that is there's two zipper pulls, one at the top and one at the bottom. Now, most of you are gonna be sitting there going, but Robo, why do I need two zipper pulls that go in two different directions form a zipper? Well, here's your answer, at least as far as I can figure it out. If you're like me, you've had to pee in the field. Now, if you've had to pee in the field with a bunch of gear on, you either take off your belt or you fight with the fact that you're gonna pull out your pants from underneath all your gear while you're trying to pull your equipment out of your pants. That happens because you're pulling down and reaching out from the top portion of the crotch porthole. Thing is, if you reach from the bottom, i.e. your zipper went up and created a hole, you could actually pull out your equipment, pee, put it back in, redo up your zipper without really disturbing the rest of your belt line. It's a really small addition, but it's actually really useful. So that's the first time I've seen that in a pair of pants. All right, time to talk about the all-important crotch. We're talking about combat pants, we're talking about movability. And movability comes with a diamond gusset in combat pants. That's what makes Cries awesome, it's what makes these awesome. Any pants that don't have that extra tailoring are just like civvy on the street clothes, and they don't incorporate features that allow maximum movability. That's what that thing does. Now, the difference between the Beyond Clothing gusset and the Cry G3 gusset is the material. In the Cry G3s, we're all used to Cry using an elastic-y kind of spandex material. In the Beyond Clothing version of the gusset, it's still elastic. It's two-way stretch elastic, but it's an elastic Cordura, just like they use on the pockets. What you're getting in this stretch Cordura is a higher quality, higher grade, and higher durability fabric than a regular plain old stretch elastic material used in the G3s. Now note, the elastic material in G3s is extremely durable. So then just count that towards how durable I think this Cordura stretch material is. All right, these will look familiar to you. Just like the Cry G3s, the A9A set do feature these front kind of thigh pockets. I find them extremely useful. Now, a slight difference that you'll notice when it comes to these pockets over the G3s. In the G3s by Cry, these pockets actually feature the tightening end of the elastic shock cord that adjusts your leg height. Now, those elastic pull tabs are not located in these pockets because they don't exist. Right. Taking a look at the side cargo pockets, these are very, very similar to Cry options, but with a few slight differences. So similarities to standard side of the leg cargo pocket. Nice deep hole, nice wide mouth to it for easy access. It's also double seamed along the front to allow it to puff out further when it's full and then to sit closer to the leg when it's empty. Again, that is almost exactly in line with the Cry options. Now, a couple differences, however. Unlike Cry, which uses two squares of Velcro on either side of the actual flap, the Beyond set actually uses one central rectangle in the middle of the pocket. Now, I can only hypothesize what this does and why they've made this decision, so here goes. Having one panel of Velcro allows you to open it with one pull. That way, you're not worried about pulling open one side of the pocket and the other one remaining stuck, therefore requiring you to attack the pocket twice. Now, most of you are gonna sit there and go, yeah, but Robo, if it sits in the middle, that leaves these flaps to be exposed to get caught on things such as branches, bushes, and blah, blah, blah. And I agree. And that's actually why I think Beyond Clothing at the ends included these little buttons that you can actually fasten the pocket down securely. Velcro's for when you need quick access, but when you know you're gonna be crawling on the ground and maybe don't need quick access, you can secure it tighter for security's sake. Another difference with these pockets, and this is kind of a negative in my opinion, there is no internal elastic system. I actually really like that in the G3s. I can put an extra magazine in there or a water bottle and it keeps it secure without bouncing around on my leg. These do not feature that. Is it a huge, huge problem for me? No, but it's still a negative I'll chalk up on the board. I think they could use some sort of organizational system in the pockets there. Another difference with these side pockets, unlike the G3s, there is no small slit in the top of the seam of the pocket to allow you to put tools, knives, things like that down into the pocket itself with quick access. Again, I also really enjoy this feature, so I'm a little bit disappointed there isn't that sort of feature set on these pants, however minor that is. So down to the all important knees, because without this knee modification, these would really be just like a basic A9A set instead of a custom set designed like G3s. So it replicates the open knee concept of the Cry G3s. It accepts Cry AirFlex pads as you see here, which I've got in Ranger Green, but there are some very minute differences that actually make this a better knee in my opinion. So while this features the Cry open knee concept, it retains a couple of the unique features from the regular A9A set that set the knee apart. The first of that is mobility tack stitching. Again, I highlighted this in my Vertex Cryptek tactical pant review. These tack stitches change the angle at which the fabric over the knee actually sits and transitions. Therefore, it actually allows you a greater mobility through that joint. The other feature it keeps from the regular A9A set is the Velcro enclosure at the bottom. Now this might not seem like a big deal, but when you're putting the pad into this little pocket, it actually helps to stick your hand up underneath, which you cannot do in the Cry G3 set. The other side of that too, the bottom of this opening means you can get any dirt, sticks, leaves, crap, rocks, magic missiles, whatever, out of your knee area a lot easier than reaching your hand in and grabbing it out there. Caveat slash downside to those who see it as such. The difference in this knee construction over the Cry G3s, the Beyond clothing set does not have an inner flap. That means if you are not wearing these without a knee pad, you have the inner fabric exposed, meaning you can wear that away and lead it to your leg. Now, for me, that's not a big deal. I wear these all the time with pads, but for those of you who are worried about that, know that there's no inner flap. Now, rounding off the bottom of the pant, just like the Cry G3s, you have the lateral pocket for extra tools, what have yous. I don't really use this pocket, to be honest, but for those of you who do, it's still on here just like the G3s. And the leg enclosure itself, again, exactly just like G3s, the Velcro enclosure, you know, so you can cinch it up to your boot nice and tight without having to blouse them. Important to note, the back of the knee is a lot different than Cry G3s. The reason being, instead of having only one attachment that goes from one side to the other via Velcro, there's actually two tabs. This allows you to better situate the knee properly over top of your own knee so you don't have it sliding around back and forth as you move. Possible downsides. This does create some extra wear at the back of your leg. I didn't find it a problem whatsoever, especially compared to other options that are out there with that kind of trait. And then the other possible downside. Velcro works on the basis of surface area. These are two smaller surface areas than the one larger surface area that Cry offers in that back attachment. So while you don't get the customizability of the back attachment in the Cry knees, I'm wondering, and I don't have the data yet, if that would be more durable. These tabs, I'm not too sure. Right now, they've been totally fine, haven't had a problem, but we'll see what happens over long-term use. So taking a look at the top half of the A9 set, this is the S9er standard issue combat top by Beyond Clothing. Now it is very similar to the Cry G3 set, so we'll just spend the time noting the differences. Similarities, stretch moisture wicking fabric at the base, nice little half collar zip. Obviously has the Nyko ripstop collar, shoulder, and arms to help take the brunt of any environmental or equipment wear. You have shoulder pockets, just like in the Cry G3 set. You have a Velcroed enclosure wrist, just like in the G3 set. And you also have a pocket area for field pads or a foam elbow pad, just like the Cry G3 set. Now, the small differences in this Beyond clothing top to the Cry top. In the elbow area, you again, like in the knees of the A9A pant, get mobility tack stitching. Again, this improves the mobility through that joint area, so you get less wear and tear on the clothing and less wear on your skin while wearing the attire. Same thing when it comes to the lip and the Velcro enclosure on the shoulder pockets as in the cargo pockets in the pants. Instead of having Velcro on each side in a small square, it's one large central rectangle. This allows you to pull once and get it open, and then when you need the extra security, there's buttons on each side. The other improvement, in my opinion, over the G3. The G3 set uses two strips of Velcro that go all the way up and down. This was a difference from the Cry AC set, which was big squares of Velcro. And that's what Beyond Clothing has decided to use. Big squares just mean that your morale patches or any kind of identifiers really stick down and can never get caught on stuff. I've had sticks and other environmental materials go up and under morale patches on the G3 and start to pull. Now, is it major? No. But is it a problem? Could be. So keep that in mind in this difference. Another slight difference in this Beyond S9 shirt over the Cry G3. The Cry G3 is a little bit longer in the length in terms of the moisture wicking fabric. The Beyond set could be longer, but it's not as bad as some of the repros out there, which are super short. They're almost like a sports bra sometimes. For a guy like me, I like it to be a little bit longer because I'm a very active mover when it comes to airsoft and firearm shooting, and therefore have a propensity to actually pull that fabric out from my belt line. I didn't have a problem with this when I was field testing it in the short amount of time I was field testing it. So just note that it's not as long as a Cry G3 top, but it's pretty much there. As I said in the review, there's some positive and negatives about the set themselves. In some areas they surpass Cry. In some areas I wish they had included some of the features found in a G3 set. So for you high use players, or for those that like to collect gear or spend a little bit extra money on getting a little extra quality out of their airsoft stuff, yes, it's absolutely unnecessary for airsoft play, but for those of you that do spend the money, you'll find no suit better than the Beyond clothing set. Now, a strong word of caution about this combat set or other items of its financial bracket. Realize that these are not necessary for airsoft use. These are real items for real world consumption that airsofters like myself who like to collect gear just so happen to purchase, pick up, and wear. At any point in time, anybody tries to tell you you need these types of items or that those items are so unnecessary to airsoft that they have an opinion on you getting or not getting these things, remember, airsoft is about what you want from it. If you like collecting gear, buy this. If you want higher durability gear than repros, buy this. If you don't have a use case that demands this or a preference case that wants this, don't spend the money. It is not necessary. These things do not give you real skills. Practicing gives you real skills. Don't let anybody tell you otherwise. As always, guys, thank you so much for taking the time to stop by and check out my content. If you can do me a huge solid, like, subscribe, and share with all your friends, it keeps me happy in this YouTube game. And that comment area down below, that's where we discuss things like if you liked or didn't like this video. So start up a conversation with me. I absolutely love to talk to you. Be sure to check out what's coming down the pike soon, which is a ton more reviews. I owe you some reviews on my sidearms, my Plat Attack jacket, and my Mars AR mag holders. So be on the watch out for those over the next week or two, because I'm gonna be releasing them in pretty rapid succession. Hey, and if you didn't hear, I'm going to Operation Copperhead, being thrown by American Milsim in Playas, New Mexico in April of this year. If you also didn't hear, I signed up or dedicated myself to COST for this event. So if you're UFS, come find me. If you're COST, let's go get them. So this pretty much wraps up this week's Robo Reviews, and until next time, guys, keep having fun playing airsoft, being good community members, and defend what you love. Later, guys.